This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Hey, Dee, I don't want to harsh your vibe, but maybe, just maybe, that's a bad idea.
Henry, Henry, Henry.
What?
You're harshing my vibe. My thinking is, I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is, I'm gonna follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are. I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine. But there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh my God, go.
I'm going. I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
Left a cassette player taped to my damn door.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Well, let's see what's on it. Us talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
What's wrong?
Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We just We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Hey, you didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
Jesus, this is a big cave. Freezing in here. Is anybody down there? Thank you. Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah, he must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Yeah, but not smarter than yours truly, right?
Wait, are you seriously feeling threatened by the intelligence of a 12-year-old you've never even met?
I'm just saying I'm pretty, with it. I'm a pretty bright bulb.
Yeah, Henry, you're a regular Rhodes Scholar.
Nice. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied. And just said it was Ned. If I routed him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
He'd hide out here to read comics. The Black Band, His Grief is His Enemy's Sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's... fucking dark.
Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him. You know, tinkering on stuff like that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker. Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever happened at their camp.
I think we'd be smart to let sleeping dogs lie.
You're probably right. Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Hey, you, might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway. See that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the June fire or the site fire? Or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
We still don't know who was listening to us, who was following me around, who made that tape.
Yeah, all we have is the body of a dead boy who did nothing wrong.
But maybe we can still find these people.
Look, I think whoever is out there caused the site fire to cover their tracks, and I'm almost certain that when I get off the helicopter, I'm going to be led into a room and made to listen to a tape of me saying we started it.
And we don't know shit. What can I do?
Well, there's something for you to do. Holy shit.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I mean, am I walking into a trap right now?
I would much rather remember you from a bar somewhere and not a jail cell. Please find who made that tape. What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
All right, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my God, Henry.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son. You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. I guess he's been dumping trash up here for a while. There's a clothesline. Everything he did to us. Everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site. God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. Brian was a nice looking kid.
Yeah.
He held on to some of Brian's things. His wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
This boombox looks familiar.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that. He had quite the view.
I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Lila, I think it was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah?
I mean, it's dangerous here, and if anything were to happen, then that would be on me, so...
Sure that's okay?
I said it was.
All right, I should go.
Have a safe flight.
All right, have a safe hike.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah? Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what. Why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe... maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
Jeez. Well, you should probably put that typewriter to good use. Hey, if you ever decide to write about this, I'd really appreciate it if you gave me a sexy accent or something that, you know, would play well in the movie version.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Maybe get a dog?
Hold on. Let me write all this down.
Whenever the season's about to wrap up, I usually find myself thinking... And when I get back, I'm gonna call him. You know, casual, and just see how he's doing. My ex. That is, I'll say something like, hey, I had a dream about you this summer and thought I'd call. You know, something that lets him know that I want him without letting him know I want him. Yeah, whatever you do, don't do that.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
Why don't you keep that luck for yourself? Bye, Hank.
than to see you walk away from me, child. Ooh. So you see, I love you so much that I don't want to watch you leave me, babe. Most of all, I just don't want to be free, no. See you walk away from me, yeah.